Let me get the camera fixed.
Oh. Hey, that's good enough. Let me get the other piece. Oh, there we go.
Thank you.
over here. Okay? As long as you understand that.
I know.
Okay. Okay.
You ready? Here it comes. You call my certainty. I wasn't knowing that you called me the sins of the
Oh,
serve the one true God. We seek my hope that's built on nothing less.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest grace, but only trust in Jesus' name.
Let's sing that again. My hope is built. And you know we need him every hour, every minute of every day. So do me a favor, let's sing the chorus of this one more time, Lord, I need you. And Lord, I need you.
I want to try my best. I want to make this as real get up on the stage, and this is going to work for us tonight. And I even brought some trash. It's not really trash. It's a bunch of my kids' stuffed animals and everything else. But here's what I want you to know. Every Thursday night was the same. Every Thursday night. Son, go get the trash. I would go through the house, and I'd pick up all the trash and put it in a trash bag, walk to the front door, and flip on the porch light, and walk outside and close the door. I'd set the trash bag down. I'd look at the can. Look at the can, look at the back. I'm scared to death because it's trash night. Is there any way possible that we can feel this? Can we pull the house lights down just a little bit? We're not all the way. I'm scared of the dark. Just prefer the light. That'll work right there. So here it is. So that's my trash can. It's my journey. I got all this. It was 7 miles, people. It was all the way across the world. I had to carry this out. Tonight's a little bit shorter. So I'm looking at the can. I'm looking at the bag. Again, I have a big imagination. So this is the point of the story where Billy has a pep rally. I got to encourage myself for about what's fixing to take place. So I'm sitting there, I'm looking at the can, looking at the bag, and I just do this little nervous hop. It's just anxiety, I guess it is. And I'm like, you got this. You got this. They ain't going to get you. They didn't get you last Thursday. They didn't get you the Thursday before that. They did almost get you the Thursday before that because your trip fell on a rock. But that's just by the point. You got this, Billy. You got this. Don't be a chicken. I mean, no, sissy, you're 16 years old. Like, are you kidding me right now? As I'm looking, I'm having this pep rally. All of a sudden, I'm looking at the can. And you know in the movie, the scary movies, when that fog starts rolling, I'm looking at this can, and all of a sudden, I'm having this pep rally, and I look out there, and all of a sudden, fog, every Thursday, starts rolling into my trash can. Now, this is the movie, this part of the movie where you know what's fixing to happen. They're fixing to get you. So I'm sitting here watching this, and I'm looking at the can, looking at the back of the can, the fog's rolling in, and in a faint distance, I can hear. You know the scary movies that have that scary stuff? And you know it's like, oh, there's a bad guy somewhere finna get you. You better not go up the stairs. I hear the music. And I probably shouldn't have did this ahead of time. I probably should have called Jason and said, Jason, I need you to help me out. I need you to find some scary music. So I'm gonna ask, what is the worst, scariest, I mean, will send shrills up everybody's spine. What's the scariest music you have? Can you play that for me right now? Oh, you ain't supposed to be looking up on them. That's a YouTube. Wait for it. You gotta listen. You hear? So here it is. Come back here. Don't look up there. Come right here. So here it is. I'm looking at the can, I'm looking at the bag, and all of a sudden the fog's rolling in. I hear the scary music. This is not Justin Bieber. And all of a sudden, I look behind the can, and I can see the bad guys. And they're in the bushes. And I want to share with you. That's good. That's terrifying me right now. That's good. That kept me alive through this moment of my life. And I want you to know this. These are the scariest 17 seconds of my life, people. Scariest 17 seconds of my life. And I want you to know I'm 34. And just this past week, I had to carry the trash can. The same things that kept me alive then is the same thing that kept me alive the other day. So here they are. I want to give this to you. So my job was, son, go get the trash. Yes, ma'am. I'm going to go get the trash. So I walk outside. I have my pep rally. I look at the can bag. I have my little pep rally going on. And I start. My Billy can't stay up here forever. You got to do this. Go get in trouble. I gotta do this. So I start walking down the steps, and I want you to know that I went to a school called Liberty Isle. If you don't know anything about Texarkana, if you don't know anything about Liberty Isle, listen to me. I got street cred. You hear me? Like it's in a bad part of the neighborhood. Like, I'm almost a gangster, almost, but not all the way there. And I learned something at the age of like maybe 6, maybe 7, and plus or minus a little bit. But I learned my first rap song. I don't need you to go Google this. I don't need you to look it up. If you know what I'm about to sing, then we can get later and we can have us a little rap concert. And I don't want you to judge me on my singing, but it was a song by Warren G. It was called Regulators. It was my favorite song to start singing. So here's what I thought. I'm like, all right, so here's what they're going to get me unless I sing a rap song. Because if I can start singing this rap song, they're like, whoa, he's a gangster. We can't mess with him. And they're going to run off. The black band's going to come up. They're going to get in. They're going to leave. Like, this is going to work for me. So I'm walking down the steps and I'm like, here we go. And I also grew up in kind of the country, so I'm not really a gangster. I'm a country gangster, if that even makes sense. But I learned that animals get scared with loud noises, so I could lean on my, let's just sing loud, it might make it better. So I'm walking down the steps and I see them back there and I'm like, all right, here we go. It's a clear black night, a clear white moon. Warren G was on the streets like, and I'm like, I sing this, like, I kill it, it's awesome. But they didn't leave. They're still there. I'm like, well, that worked. But I have another tactic, and it's the best one ever. So I'm singing a song. This is number two. If you take notes, you should write this down, because this one you probably done. So I'm singing a song. It's a clear black night, a clear white moon. This is what I do. And I'm like, what? Oh, hold on, man. It's, I see you behind that bush. You ever do that before? Don't leave me up here all by myself. You ever walked in your house scared to death? Because houses always make noise, and you hear something. You're like, oh, hey, man, I hear you upstairs. Like, the bad guy's gonna come out. Like, maybe next week we'll try it again. Like, it's not really gonna work, but I thought it was gonna work. So I'm like, oh, hey, oh, man, I see you. I see you over there. But they didn't leave. They're still there. So I'm like, all right, dude. I want to go one more step. I got two steps from the trash can. Man, this is the time for you to pull me up. So, man, I'm close to it. And I know in the movies, I watched enough of them, that the moment that they get to the trash can and they drop it in there and they turn, this is when you hear the, and they come back, they grab you, they throw you in the van, you never see your people again. So I know what's going to happen. And I developed a move, and I'm going to share it with you. Never shared this with anybody else for good reason. But it's called the, you ready for this? Take a note, write this down. It's called the DPR. The DPR, you ready for this? This is what it looks like in slow motion. Here it is, it's called DPR. Drop, pivot, run. And you laugh, it'll save your life one day. So here I am, I'm at the can, and I'm worried, scared to death about what's going to happen. I'm looking at the bush, and I can see them looking at the bush, looking at the can, looking at the bush, and I'm like, all right, Bill, it's a DPR. But there's really another letter. I don't know if I can tell you on this, but I think I can. It's not really DPR, it's really DPRS. S means scream, so it's drop, pivot, run, scream, all the way back to the house. And that's what I would do. I would get there. I was so fast. Listen to me. From here, it's like 7 miles back to the house. Before it hit the ground, Billy was already back in the house. The NFL combine, they're like, hey, we want you 440 flat, sign this man up today in like third grade. Like, this is a good thing. So here I am, I'm at the kid. I see it. It's that moment. You've got to kind of get your foot right. DPRS, DPRS. And all of a sudden, it is drop, pivot, run. Ah! All the way back. The steps, people, that I walked down, didn't even eat them. I jumped clear over them. I ran in the house, shut the door, put my hands on it, locked it back. Parents, I'm like, they're coming. Parents, like, who's coming? I'm like, the bad guys. They're like, go to bed. Now, can I tell you something that's even, it's a true story, scary 17 seconds of my life. But can I tell you something else that's probably more interesting, I would have to say? If it was a Thursday night and one of my friends come over, and we're just going to go with the same person I always use, his name's Josh. We were good friends in high school. And if he came over on Thursday night, we ate, it's getting close to dark time, and mom's gone and said, take out the trash! My whole night is completely different. I go get all the trash, and I'm like, hey, come on, let's take out the trash. I don't turn the porch light on. I don't have my little pep rally. I'm like, come on, you got this. I don't do anything. And there's no fog this time. There's no crazy music. All of a sudden, I start walking down the stairs, and there's no rap song. There's no hey, I see you in the bushes. There's no DPRS. There's not any of that. Matter of fact, it's completely different. Like, now, I'm a completely different person. The way I act, the way I talk, the way I kind of walk, the way everything about me is different because he's here. Matter of fact, the scaredy cat I used to be, now when we're walking, I'm like, chatting him up, blah, 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 like, rah. I try to scare him, like, man, don't be scared. I do this all the time. Do you want to, like, go walk around the neighborhood, like, in the dark? Like, we do that because I'm not scared of the dark. I'm not no chicken. I'm a completely different person because he's with me. Tonight, I want to talk with you about the power of presence. The power of presence. You understand this. Have you ever been playing basketball or baseball? You and a couple of your boys are all together, and then all of a sudden, some girls show up. And then boys, they start acting completely different, like it was calm and collective, and now they almost get in a fight. It's the presence. Somebody came into the situation, and everything changed. Everybody started acting different. It's the power of presence. Hey, students, I want you to know I'm excited about tonight. I'm pumped about tonight to share with you about Christ's presence in our life, how it changes everything we do. But can I tell you why I'm excited? Can I tell you why Jason Prune is excited that you're here? Can I share with you why the camp staffers are excited that you're here? Can I share with you? your pastor, youth pastor, children's pastor is so excited that you're here. Because this is what we believe. They've been praying. Everybody's been praying for you. And we believe with every ounce of our being that the way you came and the way you left is going to be completely different. Because we believe that the power of Christ's presence is going to come into your life. It's going to change everything. You're going to be a completely different person. And we can't wait to see that. I'm going to tell you here in just a few little bits before I have an invitation. If God is moving in your life, and you want to give your life to Christ, and if you want Him to come in and change everything you do, we want to give you that chance to respond. But before we get there, I want to share a couple things. I want us to look at three people tonight. And I want you to see the power of Christ's presence in their life, how they start. I want you to see the impact and how they live differently. But before we do that, would you pray with me? I want us to spend just a little bit of time in prayer, and I really want you to work with me on this. I want you to repeat this prayer after me. Would you pray with me, dear Lord? Ooh, that's not good. Let's try this again. Dear Lord?
Dear Lord.
I'm here.
I'm here.
I'm ready.
I'm ready.
I'm listening.
I'm listening.
What you say.
What you say.
And where you lead.
Where you lead.
I'll follow.
I'll follow.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Tonight I want to talk with you about the power of Christ's presence